What is up, everyone? Welcome back to Let's Play Dark Souls 2. Last time I picked up the Crypt Black Sword at long last, still don't quite have enough strength to wield it in one hand. So its use is going to be a little bit limited for the time being, but I'll get there in due time. I also beat the Duke's Dear Freya and talked about the lore surrounding Seldora, the Duke, Freya, and Ornifex. I'm going to talk about that a little bit more later on, because I haven't finished saying my piece about them yet. Ah, shit dog. One thing though, I forgot to mention last time when I was fighting the Duke's Dear Freya, is the Norse goddess of beauty and fertility also shares the name Freya. Maybe it's intentional, maybe that's something worth thinking about. Especially with some of the theories I was throwing around last time. It's definitely worth considering.
Undead! Undead! He rends the fourth bell! The great bell of Orkin. The bell belongs to the princess, it do. Stay back or we slice you to bits. Me and my chums, we shan't be miffed. Stay back all your pieces. Tiniest pieces. A long, long, long time ago, the princess, she made me. Yes, just like so. To guard this bell for the prince's honor. Stay away, foul undead, or you'll be a goner. Stay back! It belongs to the princess, it do! You wish to guard the bell, you do! For the prince and the princess forever! For true. Useless fool. Filth! Be gone right now!
Oh, I love that guy. Reminds me of one of the psycho midgets from Borderlands, except with more rhyming. Just a little bit unstable. Gotta love it. He is the patron of the Bellkeeper Covenant. The Bellkeepers invade people who trespass in the Belfry Luna, or the Belfry Soul, which is later on in the Iron Keep, which we haven't even actually unlocked yet. We'll be doing that after we go through Sinner's Rise. Being in the Bellkeeper's Covenant also has a chance to spawn a samurai enemy in the Belfry Soul that sometimes drops a special katana and a special armor set. But both this chance for him to spawn and his drop rate for those items, they're both pretty low as far as I'm aware. Now, there is a fog gate behind me. Didn't know if you were able to get a good look. If not, you'll get a good look in a moment. But it was covered up by a portcullis. So we have to first come up here, shit, to an area that I hate in order to pull this lever. And gain access to the fog gate where we can fight an optional boss, and that is what we're doing here in the Lost Bastille and Belfry Luna. We are here to fight an optional boss, and then we'll continue on the critical path to Sinner's Rise to fight the Lost Sinner, the third of the Great Souls, and the third of the Primal Bonfires. Well, I guess the Lost Sinner's not the bonfire, but whatever. You know what I mean. So I don't like fighting all of those, the Bellkeepers up there, especially not the Black Phantom one. They are assholes. Their weapons are enchanted in some way. I think they're, again, dark enchanted or infused. You hear me mix those words up a lot. And if you try to separate them a little bit, try to line of sight them and get them to come at you one by one, they just stubbornly stand still and fire at you with crossbows. So I will sooner just run past them and try to get myself in a favorable position to ring the bell and open up the gate before I ever consider fighting them. Don't like fighting them at all. Even these ones one-on-one while not difficult, they can be a little bit more annoying than I would prefer, but it's better than trying to just run past them to the fog gate and getting hit, because if I haven't mentioned it before, one of the new features in Dark Souls 2 is you can now cancel out of entering a fog gate, and you can also be hit out of entering a fog gate. So this music should sound pretty familiar, and if it doesn't, hey, a gargoyle! Everyone loves gargoyles, and we start the fight off with two of them this time. A lot of people consider the gargoyles to be one of the hardest bosses of Dark Souls 1, but you only fight two of them total in the first game, and the second one only comes in when the first one hits 50% HP. In this fight, you fight, I think, a maximum of six, and they all share this linked health bar, and as that bar drops, more of them become active. You can have quite a few of them active at a time. I've seen as many as four or five. The average is usually going to be at least three at a time. So it's ideal to focus them down instead of spreading your damage out so you don't have as many of them active at a time. You want to kill the ones you're working on. That's not always a possibility. Unless you're being super patient and you're just not attacking them when you get the opportunity to attack. If you're just waiting for the opportunity to attack the already weakened ones, that will save you a headache down the line, but that requires a little bit of patience. Now, one thing that does make them manageable, just like it was the situation in Dark Souls 1, is that usually at least one or two of the active ones, I have four up right now, usually at least a few of the active ones at any given time will keep their distance and they'll breathe fire at you. So if you're just making your way back and forth across the rooftop going from end to end, you can usually separate them this way. You can usually take advantage of the fact that they take a long time to complete their attack animations, their fire breathing animations. Do I have five up? Yeah, this is what I was talking about. Finish your plate. Instead of spreading the damage out. But I mean, the damage is already done on my end. I've already dropped enough of them down to like a quarter to half health that I have this many up, so I might as well just deal with it. Might as well just keep doing what I'm doing. Do whatever works. I don't have a shield on for this fight because, honestly, there's no point. I feel like a shield would make me too reckless because I would try too hard to block them instead of doing the smart thing here, which is just managing my stamina effectively and dodging out of the way. There are too many of them to really try to block hits from multiple gargoyles and then try to retaliate and then try to back off. You'll leave yourself stamina starved like that. So let's see, how many of that is... Oh, they're already mostly dead. I think these are the last three. This one's on his last leg, so I shouldn't have gotten desperate and tried to finish him. Ooh, also, I believe that's a new attack. I've never seen the ones in Dark Souls 1 do that. Try to separate them a little bit. Should be fine. I felt comfortable attacking that one in the back because the one who just hit me with his flame breath had just finished breathing fire before that, so he was recovering. Honestly, as long as your roll timing is good for this fight, you're not in nearly as much danger as you think. That's not good though. They do give you a lot of breathing room, so you just kind of have to be a little bit bold. Just don't get too overwhelmed with the prospect of fighting this many gargoyles at a time, and as I say that, I make some major, major mistakes. Oh, that's the best luck. I love when they're all the way across the room and they start breathing fire. It's like an opportunity to do whatever you want. Coat your weapon with something, you know, buff up, heal. And this is done. Oh no! And my roll timing is shit, too. Still, though, not that bad. Not that bad. It helps that you're not fighting them super early this time. Like, in Dark Souls 1, they're... what, the second boss you're likely to fight? Here, though, you have a lot more time to prepare and get ready. Now we'll come downstairs. I want to say there's a chest here? Is that right? Yeah. And I do not remember what's inside. Ah, the Southern Ritual Band. That's not bad at all. I believe the Southern Ritual Band increases the number of attunement slots you get. I'm about to be invaded by... what's his name? Borgol the Sinner? There he is. I am going to approach this fight the same way I would approach fighting Capra Demon, which is to take advantage of the stairs, get the dogs to bottleneck themselves on the stairs and finish them off one by one or two at a time before I actually engage the Phantom. That way I will not have as much to worry about. But of course he would make it up the steps before the dogs, why not? There's, what, three left? Back up the stairs, just keep doing that over and over. Until there are no more dogs left. Oh, he keeps making up the stairs first. And the weapon swing messed me up. That's fine though. I believe the dogs are building bleed up on me. Unless that was... no, Vorgol hasn't hit me yet, I don't think. Get down there! Oh, wait, there's one more dog behind the corpses. Dog camouflaged himself amidst the corpses of his fallen brethren. Alright, now that Vorgol's all on his own, this won't be a problem. Love the way this thing sends him flying back. The moveset on the Crypt Black Sword is not that great. There are a lot of things I actually don't like about this weapon, but I'm gonna stick with it because its base damage is enormous, and because I've spent so much effort getting it. What is that called? The sunk cost fallacy? Yeah, in this case, the cost being just sheer effort. Sunk so much effort into acquiring this at this juncture in the game that might as well stick with it. And yeah, it does have huge, huge base damage. It is an A scaling for dark. Once you upgrade that, the Crypt Black Sword a couple of times, the dark scaling goes up to S. So it does do quite a huge amount of damage. There is not much else in the game like it in terms of just raw damage output. The things that I'm not a big fan about, I'm not a big fan of with this weapon, the range and the moveset both leave a little bit to be desired. The greatsword, for instance, has a much higher range, lower damage, but a moveset that I'm a little more partial to. Also, I cannot for the life of me remember where to go. Don't want to go back down there, all the dogs respawned. The Crypt Black Sword's okay, though. But just as a raw damage output weapon, it is sick. Kind of, if only it had the range of, like, the Dragonbone Smasher, that would be sick. That said, it's not... I'm ragging on it a little bit. It's not entirely worthless or anything. But when you compare it to the Greatsword, it's lacking both the range and, the desirable moveset of that weapon. But anyway, we're now finished up with Belfry Luna, at least for the time being. Might head back there just for one little thing later on. But real quick, I want to talk about what the deal behind the Bellkeepers are. the reason that they're charged with guarding bells in Belfry Luna and Belfry Soul, and the two bells represent the star-crossed love of a prince and a princess. Now, considering where the bells are located, Luna and Soul, Moon and Sun, that sounds an awful lot like Guinevere and Gwendolyn had some sort of forbidden romantic relationship going on, which, not a big fan of the incest. I know that's such a controversial statement and all. Not a big fan of incest. But yeah, that seems to be a strong hint. Because Gwendolyn's aspect was the moon, and Guinevere was the princess of sunlight. Oh, you're not surprising me. Pyromancy jailer? Almost surprised me. Surprised me a little bit. If I'm being honest. I mentioned the Bellkeepers were a PvP covenant. So, it's probably worth talking about a new mechanic they introduced that actually affects PvP and actually co-op as well. Invasions and summons are now affected by a new mechanic called Soul Memory. The way it used to work was you had a level range for people you could summon or be invaded by. So a level 50 could never be invaded by, say, someone who is soul level 200. The formula, man, off the top of my head was, I think it was plus your level plus or minus 10% plus 10. So at level 100, you could summon people from, why did I choose to do math? 80 to 120. And then there would be specific exceptions made for certain covenants and items. Like, I think Dark Moon Blades could be much higher level than you and invade you when punishing people. But now there's a new system called Soul Memory, which isn't based on your soul level at all, but rather how many total cumulative souls your character has acquired. And nobody is totally sure of what the ranges are right now. But it's speculated that the range increases as your soul memory goes up. And this has been a pretty controversial change. Largely because it means you can actually be very low level, but have a high soul memory and be invaded by people who are much higher level than you. Just because the nature of the way it works, it's not based on your level, it's based on how many souls you've acquired. So if you're a low level and you've been grinding souls out, maybe to buy something or to do something else with those souls, then suddenly you can find yourself being matched up with people who have just dumped all of their accumulated souls into leveling up. But the fact that the game is still so new, I mean, it is only coming up on a couple of weeks old and coming up on a month probably by the time this goes up. And the fact that so much of it is still not entirely clear, the specific level ranges and stuff like that, or the summon ranges, I should say, there is a lot of room to explore and figure out how this works and why it might not be such a bad change. Could be wrong, though. It could be the worst thing ever. And we've just hit the tip of the iceberg in terms of how bad it is. Still a lot of unknowns left to explore in this game. And I've talked about it before. That's what I really love about this series, is those unknowns, that aspect of the unknown that is so, so prevalent. Down here, I think there's a jump I can make, but first I'm going to get in the cage before I go after... There it is, that item on the ledge, on the corpse. Because I think I can get some bonfire aesthetics down here. Or no, I think the corpse actually has bonfire aesthetics on it. So, what is in the chest then? Anything important in here? Yeah, the bonfire aesthetics are up on that corpse, so in the chest, wilted herb. Nice. It's nothing. And on that note, we'll leave off for now. We're gonna be coming up to Strayed pretty soon, so next time we'll rescue him, and we'll do the Lost Sinner. Thanks for watching, everyone. Take it easy. Have a good one.